مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ Allah says, what's Allah going to get out of punishing you? That's what Allah says Himself. What is He, what is He in just the business of coming after you? Going at you? So what happens with people? They are in a difficult situation. And what do? They're constantly thinking Allah is getting them. Allah is hurting them. Allah is doing this to them. You know, I was reminded by a colleague of mine. I was just, when I was coming here to Malaysia, out of nowhere, this has never happened. I developed this crazy bacterial infection thing in my tonsils, and it swelled up, and my half of my neck was completely blocked, and I felt like I was drowning in one nostril, and I'm still on the plane, and I get halfway through to Abu Dhabi on the way here, I run over to a clinic, and they say, you have to, you know, take these heavy medications. I come here, the recommendation is I should go to surgery. I was like, what is going on? This is, and they even told me, this never happens. Like, this is really crazy. This is, I've in my entire career of 30 years, I've seen like one other case of this. And I'm lying there in the hospital bed waiting for a surgery to take place. And I'm thinking, and I was reminded by a colleague, this is the best place you could have been. Like, there's no better place than this hospital bed for you at this moment. That is Allah's plan for you. Here I am thinking I have to cancel this program. I can't go over here. I can't go over there. How are we going to manage this situation, that calendar, that meeting? All this way, I came all this way, and now look, I didn't get to do this, that, or the other. And then all of a sudden, just that little reminder, you're just like, yeah, this is the best place I should be. There's no better place, because this wasn't planned by me. This was planned by Allah Azza wa Jal. This is entirely planned by Allah. We have to have a closeness to Allah that when He plans something for you and me, even when it's painful, He doesn't do it for anything except love. That Allah Azza wa Jal loves His ibad. That He loves what is best for them. He loves us more than we could ever love ourselves. He cares more for us than we can ever care for ourselves. He provides us more than we could ever provide for ourselves.